Old School Bodybuilding Clothing Company. If you wish your fancy fitness center was a hardcore gym, you are old school. If you just ate chicken and rice and are about to eat chicken and rice, you are old school. OSBBC.com for the hardest training athletes.
This is Dave Palumbo with an RX Muscle news update. I'm here with Nathan D'Ascia, IFBB Pro, and he is having some tremendous drama going on at his gym over there in the UK. If anyone has looked at his Instagram, you can see the cops have been there. They've tried to shut him down. They've been trying to fine him $1,000 or £1,000 per hour. Nathan, what's going on out there at the gym? Tell us what happened.
Cheers, Dave, for having us on. As you know, the whole COVID thing is going crazy right now. In my country, in the UK, lockdown ended 11 weeks ago. Then they tried to put us in a city-wide lockdown and possibly put everything into four or five sectors. And my sector being leisure, then which has the lowest COVID rate, things just wanted to close us down. Other cities are in the same tier, which is a tier three, which is a high risk. But Liverpool, where I live right now, it's not even the highest infection rate, you know, and that's proven with all the stats, but yet they still want to lock us down and shut us off.
So the other day, you're at the gym, I guess, working out, just like you always do. Next thing you know, the cops show up. What do they say to you? Like when they knock on the door, do they say, excuse me, we got to close you down? I mean, what would they say?
So what happened, Dave? I'd literally finished training. I literally got round the corner. I was a minute, 2 minutes away. The reception staff, the girl, my cousin, she phoned me panicking. The police are here. We had one big police van with armed police officers come to the door. So I walked to the door. The gym was all blacked out at the time then. The girls turned the lights off and everyone kept on training in the dark. All you heard is steel just clashing. I just said, I'm going to help you. You know, firstly, they're very abrupt in my face. And then we got the camera out and then they just changed the attitude. I understand they have a job to do, which they're just enforcing their job from their hierarchies. And they were just like saying, look, you have to close the gym. And I was like, why? Like, oh, it's law. So it's not law. It's not even legislation. It's a guidance. Right. So I was just explaining my view and saying, look, the stats show that in our leisure, we've had 360 million gym visits since gyms have been open. And we've had 278, you know, confirmed cases of COVID. So I'll let you do the maths on that and tell me what the reason I have.
Is there really an outbreak by you guys? I mean, has it really increased? I mean, or are they making this stuff up?
It hasn't increased, Dave, whatsoever. It's increased because they've opened more test centers. So the more test centers you open, the more infection you're going to get. Also, it's being put out there in the media that the government sent out home kits that were already COVID positive anyway. Students are using positive COVID positive tests to send them back, and all they've done is apologize. So, if you have more test centers, more people are going to get tested, right? So, it's a thing that's up in the air, you know. And the first lockdown, we abided by every single rule. This one,
has one person tested positive in your gym?
Not one person tested positive in my gym. We have all the necessary equipment, sanitized stations. We get it cleaned every 4 days by a company that comes in, does a 4-hour clean. The girls clean it dramatically every single day, up to 6 times a day. We have masks there. We have gloves. You want to wear them. That's all down to yourself. These guidelines were in place, you know, from the government. They're like a 98-page document that you have to abide by to open the gym. They came. They said we're okay. And as of now, we are the safest sector. But yet they want to take that away from us. And, you know, we've had many people and friends who took the life because of this. And the gym is their only escape, you know. And
A lot of suicides that have been increasing. And I'm not saying that, you know, like people like Luke Sandow's, you know, could have been attributed to this, but it could have been. But we're talking about people with mental health issues that like to use the gym as their therapy in a sense, you know?
Yeah, we've had, you know, mental and physical, you know, and we're trying to take strain off the NHS or National Health Service and help them, you know, and the main cause of COVID deaths is obesity. To combat obesity, you need fitness, right? And we are the fitness industry. So to close us is just, you know, it's just anti-effective. So we are.
It's funny how the government people who are the guys that don't work out, who are out of shape and in the worst shape possible, those are the guys making the laws against the gyms. Meanwhile, you know, other businesses are open. I mean, how they determine that the gyms are not, you know, necessary, it's ridiculous. If you go to the gym and you work out on a regular basis, you would know that the gym is a necessary, it's part of healthcare. If the hospitals are open and the doctors are open to treat sickness, why wouldn't the things that prevent sickness be open? That's the stupidity of declassifying the gym as a non-priority type of situation.
Yeah, Dave. You know, we have a lot of health service workers in our gym, in our facility. You know, and even they said we've had no cases of COVID. You know, and even regarding the gym, and you know, the government states, you know, sitting hospital is that its max? But then you ask the hospital, well, how many COVID beds do you have? They say eight. Well, eight your max, right? So you are at your max. You've got eight beds. So. You, in a way, you aren't lying, but in a way, you're telling you're misinforming the people. So you know we're just trying to help do our part, but yet we're being punished for that. And you know, basically, the governments are off base taking our livelihoods and just giving us crumbs. You know, like they expect us to live off $5 an hour. You know, and how can you live with that? And what they've offered us to close my gym, it doesn't even cover 4 to 5 days' rent.
Bullshit. I don't know why they don't consider preventative medicine. Okay. And we're talking real here. We're not trying to make up some semantics so that we can get your gym open. The gym working out is preventative medicine. Preventative medicine should be as important, maybe more important than medicine that treats actually sick people. Because if you keep more people healthy, you're going to have less sick people, but I understand that's not good for business of the hospital. So they want sick people. That's the problem.
Yeah, they want them, you know. And even when the police are there, they, like I said before, they have a job to do. They didn't want to issue the fine.
Of course not.
They were just doing their job. And off camera, when their cameras come off, they said, look, the hierarchy says we have to give you the fine. And because you were basically the forefront, you know, to do this whole thing, we basically came here. So I said, look, you know, I appreciate it, but, you know, I'm standing up for my members. The first time, we abided by it. This time, I don't think it's right. And I've seen so many people get ill, pass away, take their own life. And I can't see that, you know. If it means me taking a fine, you know, for believing what I believe in, then so be it, you know. And I just said to them, so I don't want to waste your time. I don't, you know, and obviously you have real crimes to do. So why don't you just, you know, I'm open 10 hours a day, you know, 7 days a week. So why don't you just fire me one big bill? I take the course and I'm still not going to pay. You know,
that's £10,000 per day, right? Because they're going to fine you. They said £1,000 per hour. They said they're going to come back every hour and give you a fine. Have they come back?
They've been outside today 7 times. You know, we basically blacked the windows out, put a black sheet in front of the workout area so you can't see in, turned the front lights off, and you know, they've tried to come in, and because, you know, I said to look, it's private property, it's my premises, you are not allowed in.
So you own the gym, is that the right? You own the land and everything?
So I said, you know, it's private. You know, when we had 2 lots today and we offered them some grenade bars and they just turned away, started laughing, you know. But all we can do is kill them with kindness. But
offer them cookies and cake and all that, and coffee. At least you can say, hey, look, you guys want to hang out here all day. You're more than here. I'll give you something to munch on a little bit. Maybe we'll give you a healthy snack so that you guys don't get any immune system compromisation, you know, going on.
You know, the members are still coming. And when the police are there, I said, look, it's still the business. You know, I'm not going to rub it in you. I'm not going to rub it in your face, but I'm still open to business and you're not welcome in. So, you know.
Maybe you should like, because I think, are restaurants open in the UK or are they shut down too?
Well, restaurants are open. Yeah, restaurants are open. Supermarkets are open. shopping centers are open. Everything corporate is open.
Just say you can just reclassify yourself. Instead of being a gym, say I sell health nutrition supplements. That's all. We just happen to have a couple pieces of equipment in the back that people can work out.
Well, we have a food prep company in the gym. So
there you go. Do that.
We've been sending lads out, you know, with cupcakes and big tubs and stuff. And you know, you bought the cake and that's it. It took you 3 hours to pick what cake you want, but you get the cake and now you've gone.
The guys at Attila Gym in New Jersey, one of the senators, state senators, set up his re-election campaign out of the gym. So they're saying the gym is actually a re-election headquarters, and it just happens to have equipment in there. And so that's how they're getting around. they're really fighting the fight. That governor hates them. He's took away their business license. I mean, he's really after them.
That's what they threatened us with it. You know, they threatened us with taking with a foreseeable closure notice. I said, okay, issue me. I'll go sell the business to my partner. And then issue them with it. I'll sell to my cousin. And so be it. But, you know, like, I ain't closing. And I stated that when I first started, I'm not closing. And I'll stick by that every step of the way because, you know, my members find me at the first closure when I could have lost the business. And I said to them, look, I'll stick by you guys because, you know, we've had a lot of people in the gym. And, you know, we offer disability classes and stuff. So it's not just a local meathead gym as people want to think it is. You know, it's basically part of the community and people come there for so many different reasons. And, that, you know, if we take that outreach from them, then what do we have? We don't have no youth centers no more for the vulnerable kids. We don't have no elderly centers. We don't have no disabled centers where we live. So we don't have nothing, you know. And
you let those kids train for free, right?
Yeah, we have some kids, you know, who've been timid from school, who the government don't want nothing to do with the parents are doing whatever they're doing, they don't care. You know, and these kids can relate to me because, you know, I've fucked up many times in my life and, you know, they see have a gym and have this and have that and, you know, they can relate to where I've been, to where I've come from. And like I say, look, you know, if you're an athlete, you're a sport, no one will judge you from your past, you know, and that you can go far. And these kids, you know, they come in the gym 6-7 hours a day. You know, they just stay there and just, you know, they ask around in the reception and they do 45 machines a day. They just don't care, you know. But for them hours, we know they're safe. We know they're off the streets. You know, they could be carrying knives, robbing houses, getting into trouble. But for them 7 hours, as much as we can do, they're in our facility and we've got them for there. So it takes a little bit of heave off the police force and resources, you know. And these kids don't want to know them, but you know, they're from our area, from our community, and we're a community based gym, and we're just trying to offer the best for our community.
Yeah, I love that little whoever drew that on the wall of your gym. That's great. the prophecy.
Yeah.
Who did that?
A guy called Snow Graffiti. Seen him do it in one gym, and then I basically said, look, you know, I want a picture of him. I want a picture, and everyone's like, oh, poor name. You know, put Ronnie Coleman there, or you know, put Dory in there. I was like, I don't like Dory physique. I was like, put Phil or Flex there, and then one of the young lads says, look, Nathan, put yourself up there. And like, I was like, nah, that's too vain. Like you know, like if you put yourself there, people can look up to that and aspire to be, you know, look over and do your own thing. And I thought, yeah, you know, I don't mind. I giggled with vain and I thought,
it's your gym, why not? You put your own picture there. Of course you do.
Yeah, and I thought, why not? And then the guy said, look, it looks good. So now it's like an attraction. People just come and take a picture there. It's a bit cheesy, but you know, I think it's fun.
I like it. No, I like it. It's your gym, man. You can do whatever you want. That's what I always say. Now, what's what's going on with the Olympia? I know you were back at Oxygen Gym. You were getting ready for the Arnold last year at the last minute. I mean, you've had a bad year. I mean, the last minute you couldn't get to the Arnold in Ohio. Then you were supposed to go to the Arnold Australia. They canceled that. I mean, come on. I mean, you just have had no luck these last 2 years.
Yeah, you know, Dave, I missed last year's Olympia for my own faults. You know, this year it's come around and it's due to this pandemic. I honestly can't do nothing about it. It's basically, you know, we're trying to go from country to country to try and get my visa sorted, you know, because over here in the UK, the US Embassy is closed and on our government website, they're not issuing an ESTA visa for tourists or not issuing any P1 visas or until December 31st. I've tried to go through December 31st, sorry. I've tried to go by the US route, and because of your political stance right now with all elections, they're too overwhelmed doing anything. So it's a nightmare, you know. We're sitting nicely now at 134 kilo, roughly 5 weeks out, I could be ready in. So we spoke to a lawyer who's got it in his hands now, and he said he should have an answer within the next 3 weeks. So, you know, touch wood, 3 weeks is enough time, I can be ready. If not, then, you know, we'll go on to next year and do the Arnold Ohio. I'm trying to get the qualification there.
Heidi Shupin from Iran got to the Olympia last year, for God's sakes. And Nathan D'Ascia couldn't. You know, he's in the most wanted country of all. Like, Trump has a ban on that country. And you couldn't get into this country because you had a silly charge on you. What's going on with that case? Is that case all settled now?
Yeah, settled, man. I got a 141 pound fine.
God, after all that, holy
man. Yeah. So it was a small fine.
Thank God. Paid off. Congratulations, you got it. Yeah.
Paid off monthly.
What's what you got? You know, I know it's this. They do it here in the U.S. too. That you get a fine and people pay it off like a dollar a month. Why don't you just pay the thing and get it off your record?
Well, it's off anyway. It's over here. It doesn't go off anyway. So as long as you pay it, it doesn't matter. It's just like a written contract, you know.
Yeah, but they can't like use that against you. Like, oh, we're not going to give you a visa because you still have an outstanding fine.
No, they just pay it off. But the court issue how you pay, you know.
I got you.
So I said okay, you know. So it was one.
He pays a pound a month. Yeah, it'll take him 30 years to pay it off.
Yeah, you know, be funny about it. But so hopefully, you know, touch wood and God give, you know, I can hopefully be there this year. If not, then you know, crack on to next year. Like I said, a lot of people wanted me to do Spain, but I said to myself, there's no point. I'm already qualified for the Olympia.
Right.
I'm not someone to trophy hunt and, you know, keep going for shows and shows. No point in that. I had the qualification. My eyes were set on the Olympia, you know. And even today, I've seen Flex Lewis. He couldn't go to the Olympia. And, you know, right now, the 2020 is just total shit on me. And,
in 2020, it seems to be messing everyone up. I mean, Flex Lewis, I mean, was planned 2 years to do the Olympia. Now, obviously, whatever's going on with him, you know, obviously you could tell in his face, you know, I mean, you said it earlier to me. He just looks like completely demoralized that he has to miss this Olympia, you know?
Yeah, it's sad, you know, sad times. And this year, I just take as a write-off, you know, and hopefully
what it looks like, yeah.
Next year, we'll be back some type of normality.
But you know what? With all the craziness that's going on, you probably really want to get on that Olympia stage because anything can happen. Who knows at this point? You could go there and you could win for all you know. You know what I mean? So I think it's an opportunity, you know?
I seen Brandon yesterday. Abdullah sent me some of this. Guy looks freaky as hell, you know? You know, one day I hope to give them a battle for up there. But I believe, you know, I could have stood my own and played really, really well this year. And
absolutely.
Everything I've basically gained since being back on oxygen, you know, I'm back to my old best and full. Good. I'm back to the full roundness, you know, and I'm healthy. So that's, you know, I'm disappointed if I don't get to showcase what I've worked hard on these last few months. But, you know, it is what it is. And basically this pandemic is more, as the world thinks it's more important, you know. But,
Keep fighting the fight over there, Nathan. I know there's a lot of the whole bodybuilding community is behind you. I know your local community is behind you. All the good stuff you do for the local community with the kids and everything like that. Yeah, I wish the governments would understand that working out and training and eating right, those are all preventative medicine. That should be lumped with the hospitals, with the essential, you know, type of things that need to be done on a daily basis for people to have good mental, emotional, physical health, and it will keep people from getting sick. During a pandemic, you don't want people getting sick and then have to treat them. You want to, isolation is not the answer. It's keep people's immune system strong, keep them feeling good so that they are exposed to it, which is invariably going to happen. Everyone's going to be exposed at some point. You want them to be able to fight the thing off, you know?
Yeah, that's what we hope. You know, that's why we believe in the fitness you wear part of the solution and not the problem, you know? Yeah. But we keep fighting the good fight over here because we believe if we go up north, then the whole country will basically go into another lockdown. And we know lockdown is not the solution. No. You know, it's more of the problem. So hopefully we just keep fighting the fight. You know, the world, like yourself, you've heard about what's been going on. And, you know, we've had guys even from like Canada, you know, basically sign up for gym memberships from a gym and say, look, you know, I'll never come to the gym ever in my life. But, you know, rather than give to the page, I'd rather see you do well. And, you know, so it's being heard everywhere. And I can't thank everyone enough, you know, for supporting me. Even you, Dave, for giving us an outlet, and everyone else just keeps getting behind us, you know. And it's a massive, massive thing. And I think if we, as a small city, can stand up to these big guys, and then the whole world's gonna start standing up and, you know, believing what they believe, what they believe is right, and fighting the good fights, and but doing it in a proper way, you know, doing it in a respectful way, and that's the main thing.
Absolutely, I agree 100%. And Nathan, you're doing a great job. I pray for you. I say a prayer every night that you can make it to that Olympia, and we see you on that stage. If not, though, I know you'll be back next year with a vengeance. So keep up the great work and keep fighting the fight, and don't pay those fines.
No way, Dave. Thank you, brother.
Tell them you'll pay it over 30 years. Tell them you'll pay $1 a month.
Will do.
All right. And guys, that's going to take us to the end of another RX Muscle News Update. Stay tuned for future updates. I'm Dave Palumbo with Nathan the Asher. We'll see you next time.